The 2,000 to 10,000 taste buds lining the tongue and parts of the mouth are receptors that predominantly only send one of five basic messages to the brain: salty, sour, bitter, sweet, and umami, which is somewhat savory. And this is it. Now, this is the human tongue. Just to point out, all taste sensations can come from all regions of the tongue. You may have seen when you were young or at school that there was a tongue map where we had sweet in the front and sour on the sides. Well, that's completely incorrect. Some areas can be more sensitive to others, but that old model was debunked years ago. Now, the point of this video is that the taste buds don't do very much. Knowing something is sweet doesn't give you flavour. Many fruits are sweet, but it's difficult to tell them apart from the taste buds' signal alone. So flavour doesn't come from the taste buds. The five primary taste receptors are far outweighed by over 300 different smell receptors in our noses, and these can collectively distinguish somewhere between 30,000 to a trillion different smells. There's a wide variety in the literature. Now, it's hard to give a precise number, but probably around 80% of the flavors in our foods come directly from our noses. We're not tasting food, we're smelling it. This, coupled with additional stimuli such as the appearance, sound like a crunch, touch, spiciness, temperature, texture, and the feel of food in our lips, even further diminishes the importance of the taste buds for enjoyment of a meal. So, the taste buds do have a role. Their sweet, salty, sour, umami, and bitter don't really give flavour, but they are predominantly for survival. For example, bitter and sour flavours deter us from eating toxic substances like rotten and rotting meat or anything spoiled or acidic. On the other hand, we're enticed to eat sweet foods as long as they're not too salty, as these are usually quite nutritious in nature. New research suggests that perhaps we have senses for fat, metallic, and carbonation tastes, but either way, that's it. The taste buds don't really add to the flavour or enjoyment that comes with eating. In fact, it's been suggested that if we all lost our sense of smell, the joy of food, as in regularly dining out to experience culinary delights, might largely disappear from society. So, the taste buds, though, do have their roles, and they're even present elsewhere in the body. Throughout the airways, the bladder, brain, testes, and the digestive tract, taste buds serve various purposes. For example, the taste bud for sugar and sweetness is located in the intestinal tract. Now, this can induce the pancreas to release insulin when it comes in contact with glucose. We don't taste it that far down the system, but the taste bud receptor is there and doing its thing. Even our digestive system doesn't respond solely to taste buds. A meal's sight, sound, smell, and touch all help to raise hunger hormone levels, get saliva flowing, and give us that rumbling tummy. So next time you have a meal, be sure to enjoy the input from every sense, as your taste buds play only a minor role in the overall experience.